Hi, welcome to TutorialsPoint. In this video, we are going to begin Microsoft SQL Server. In this video series, we are going to cover so many concepts regarding the T SQL, which will help you out to do the several operations in a database. As database is a very important part of our daily life as well as in the software development, so it is very good to be going through this particular tool as it is quite famous tool, and so many organizations and in so many projects this particular product has been used. So before getting started with this SQL Server, let's check what this database is all about. So basically, database is something which provides a base to your data. That means you can store your data permanently in order to get the details again whenever it is required. So while working with the database, you will observe that we are going to work with so many different database objects such as tables, which will provide the main task of a database, that is the storing of the data. Storage of the data is the first thing that we require, and that particular task will be done by the tables itself. So it is one of the objects. Now when we have the data, we can do several things in order to provide some restriction to the access, in order to provide some performance benefits, or in the security points. So we would be having a different type of database objects here, which will do these different tasks. But first thing that we need to ensure is, when we are storing the data, we have to make sure that we can retrieve it whenever we want. And to provide all such things, we have something called the DBMS, called Database Management System. Means it's all about managing your database. So basically, it is nothing but a software application which will ensure that the data is being stored in a tabular format probably, and anyone, whenever you want to retrieve that data, it will also ensure that you can retrieve that as well. So apart from that, it is designed to allow the definition, creation, querying, update, or administration of the databases. As while working with the database, we have to go through all these things. Apart from that, data sharing, data security, integration, access, these are the major advantages which will be ensured by the DBMS. But this DBMS will be even more powerful when we add a concept of relationship. As when we talk about a database, suppose I want to create a database for my organization, TutorialsPoint, how can I do that? First of all, I'll have to break all our requirement into smaller pieces. For example, one requirement is to store the information of all the employees, about the products, about the tutorials that we have, about the departments. So all these are the different entities which we need to deal with. But obviously, since we are employee and we are working in any department, so yes, definitely these are the two different entities, department and employees, but ultimately somewhere we are related. Every department would be having some employees, every employee would be having in a department. So that particular relationship is produced by this RDBMS, and which is written and defined by E.F. Codd, who was a research scientist in IBM. So basically, he provided some rules, 13 rules, using which you can actually deal with that. The rules begins with the rule 0 to rule 12. So in total, it is a 13 rules. So this is being written by this E.F. Codd. The major purpose of the relation model is to provide something, a declarative method for specifying data and queries. That means a user or any software application which would be querying from a database will provide all the details, like how they want to store the data and how they want to retrieve it. And whenever you want to do any communications like that, whether a user or a software application is requesting a database for some data, or requesting a database to write some data, we will be using a language, and that language is nothing but the SQL, that is structured query language. So basically, this SQL is designed in 1974 by Donald Chamberlain and Raymond Boyce. So these couple of guys actually created a generalized language which is not particular to any for a tool. But in so many RDBMS, we will be finding that SQL is the common language that is being used. It is very simple to understand as it is very much similar to the English language. So even if someone not familiar with the SQL and he reads the SQL statement, he will understand, okay, what this statement meant. So that is why it is being categorized in the fourth generation language. So using this fourth generation language, you can actually make a communication with the database, and that is all it is designed to do. But while working with the SQL, you will observe like we have to do some different type of task. So what we can do on the basis of the different tasks performed by this SQL, we can classify it into several parts. That is the data definition language, in short DDL, data manipulation language, DML, data query language, DQL, data control language, and transaction control language. So let's discuss about these. Data definition language, as the name says, it is about the defining. Means while working with the database, if you are defining a new database object, as in the very beginning I said, like here we'll be working with the different database objects. So here the different database objects, whenever we will define different database objects, it will be data definition language. In short, I can say any SQL command which actually makes the changes in the structure or in the metadata of a database, we will categorize that SQL command in the SQL. So whenever you will create something, so it will obviously affect the structure of the database, so it is a DDL command. Similarly, once you have created an object, now if you want to alter the structure, it will also affect the structure of the database. So again, alter is the DDL command. Similarly, if you are dropping an object, it will affect the structure, it will be categorized in DDL. But once an object is created, suppose a table is created, what next thing you will be doing? You will write some data into it, like one record, two record, and so on. So whenever you will add a new record, that will be a DML, that is data manipulation language. Any SQL command which will change the data in a table will be categorized in data manipulation language. So whenever you are inserting a new row or updating the existing record or deleting an existing record, it will be categorized under data manipulation language. Now, next one, very important one, and the query and the statements, SQL commands, which we fire in the maximum cases is the data query language. It will only read the data from the table, it will not affect the data inside a table. So whenever you want to retrieve the information in customized way or normally as it is stored, whatever you want to do, whichever way you want to choose, you will have to go for the data query language. So even in SQL, here we will begin with the data query language, that is the select statement. Once you will do that, you will be able to retrieve the data from one or multiple tables logically. Now here we'll be talking about data control language. Data control language is used to authorize the users. As here we are working in a centralized database, so it is very essential to give different set of permissions to the different user sets. So we can use the grant command in order to give some permissions and revoke command or deny command to take the permissions back. Similarly, now next is transaction control language. Suppose I want to transfer some amount from my account to my friend's account. So it is nothing but a transaction. So transaction word actually ensures a complete process. When I'm transferring the amount is getting deducted from my account and being added on his account. Similarly, whenever you'll be doing anything like that, I want to ensure that either the transaction should be completed completely or it should not be done. If there is a failure, I don't want half of the transaction is done and half is failed. We will ensure if it is a failure, we will not do anything. Means even the amount will not be deducted from my account. Obviously, then the account will not be added on some other's account. But if the transaction is complete, it will ensure the consistency of the data. If it is complete, it will be completed fully, or it will be done, it will not do even single thing. So this is all about the transaction. So using all these things, we can actually do a lot of things in our database. So it was all about generalized things here. Like here, I didn't talk about the SQL server things, but we just talk about the database, about the SQL. Now, in our next video, we'll see some of the features of our SQL server provided by Microsoft.